Hi there, I'm Paula McCoy, and today I'm going to show you how to do a watercolor background on the back of your glass. First, what you do is you clean your glass, and then you're going to spray it with water, and I've just got a fine mister that you can find at like a Walmart, or this particular one I found at a Sally's Beauty Salon. It just has a nice fine spray. Pre-mix all your colors. I'm going to start out with 324, and it is yellow ochre, and I've pre-mixed it to like a melted ice cream or a honey type consistency. And you want to work fairly quickly when you start this, and I'm just grabbing some of the yellow and adding it to the water that's on there and kind of mushing it around and letting it blend in. See how that's a little bit thinner? There's not as much color down here. We're going to have 6 or 7 colors, so you want to divide the distance of your piece of glass. I have an 8x8 that I'm working with. Okay, so there's my yellow, and now I'm going to pick up my 318, which is pumpkin. And again, it's pre-mixed, kind of overlap the colors so that they blend together. And what I'm doing is just kind of swishing it around. I'm using the #1 liner, Tacklon liner. And you can see how it kind of muddles and starts to blend together. And depending on how much product or color you put on there will determine how dark this is going to be. The water will make it a little bit thinner on the background. Okay, see how that kind of starts to blend. If you feel like you need a little bit more water, because it will evaporate, you can mist it again as you're working, and that also causes it to blend and muddle and fade into each other. The other thing that you can do is pick up the glass and you can cause it to run into each other also. And you can see even after I mix it, it starts to settle down and it kind of blends together. You want it to look fairly natural. And then the next color that I'm going to use is 330. I have it mixed in a little pod. Some of the colors that I use more often, I mix up in my jar, the actual color in that jar, and just leave it that way if I'm going to do a lot of backgrounds. Okay, so I'm going to add the pinks. This is a pink. This is Blush Cabernet 330. And they tend to burn out a little bit, so go a little heavier with that color. Can you see how I'm just kind of blending it into that orange? Be careful and don't leave any drips that would show. You want to make it look more like it's an airbrushed or watercolored background. And I'm just going back and adding as I feel I need some. Got a little area up here that's a little thin. See, I dripped it there, so you need to kind of blend that in together. And I even go back at the very end if I see an area that maybe has ran a little bit. You can also pull the colors into each other that way. This particular one, I want it nice and soft. And if you need to, rinse your brush. I'm going to rinse my brush so that I don't carry any more of that color into that orange. Okay, and you can see down here how it's starting to run a little bit. Close that one back up, and now we're going to go to a purple. Again, pinks and purples tend to burn out a little bit, so go a little heavier. And I'm trying to work real fast for video time, so I'm having some splatters here. But that's okay, because they'll just blend in. And of course, the purple's darker than that pink, so you need to blend it a little more, spend a little more time with it. Just kind of mushing it around, making some circles to try to fade out the colors. And then I'm even going to tip the glass a little bit and let that run. You see how that's running a little bit into some of the other. I'm going to tip it towards the camera now so you can see it run there. Okay, so you can get different variations. I have laid this on a paper towel, and I'm working on top of a light board. The reason I'm on the paper towel is it's going to absorb any of the water or color that falls off the edge, and it's easier for cleanup at the end. Okay, I'm going to go back. I want this purple to be a little heavier, and you can see how it faded out here in the middle. because it was running. And again, this is starting to get a little dry over here. It's evaporating, so I'm going to go back and mist that area so that it's prepared for the next color. Okay, I like the way that looks. I'm just going to kind of wipe my brush off on the paper towel. And now we're going to go to 351, which is our cerulean blue. Again, all your colors are pre-mixed and ready to go, so that you can just jump from one color to the next. Okay. And depending on how much of that color you want showing on your background, this is a background that I'm using on my toucan, and it's a tropical type setting. So I want like the sun up here where the yellow is shaded, and coming down into the bird that's going to sit in the middle of the design. And I'll show you that later. And then it kind of fades out to from sun to sky and then into more of a grassy type setting. Okay, I'm going to rinse my brush. I see like a little chunk here, and I want to mush that out. I don't want that to end up being a solid area, so I probably had a little crumb that just fell off my jar, or it could have been something that wasn't mixed up thoroughly. Okay, now you see when I go back over that, it kind of separates it. You can mist that and kind of let it variegate and flow in. I'm going to tip this again and let that run in a couple of directions. I'll tip it towards the camera so you can see that. See the blues running? Okay, so now that's just made a lighter spot, but I know that's where my design's going to be, so I'm not worried about it. Okay, the next color that we're going to do is 360 Key Lime, which is our lightest green that we have. And again, I've mixed this. I happen to have this particular color in a pod. The pods are great because you never waste. Of course, your jars are too. You can mix your color up in them with your medium and then close them up. Come back, reconstitute them, just stir them up. They're basically like powder. They do separate. The medium separates from the color, but that's okay because you can just add more medium and continue. So you never lose anything. You don't waste anything, which is great for cost. And these colors are available in a 1 ounce. This is a 1 ounce jar that I've got here that has the cerulean in it. And then we have a larger jar that's a 2 ounce and a 4 ounce for those that do production work, or maybe you're a teacher and it's more economical. And you can find those on our website at colorsforearth.com. Okay, and I'm going a little heavier again with this green. I want more of the grassy area. I've got one more color that I'm going to go on to. Okay, and I'm going to tilt this again just slightly and let that green kind of run into that blue a little bit. It almost gives you like a tie-dyed look. The last color that I'm going to use on this corner is called Aqua Splash, and it's kind of a turquoisey aqua color. Strong. That's why I'm only using a small amount over here on the corner. If you have an area that doesn't want to take the product, where it seems to be repelling, just kind of push a little harder on the brush and smush it around in that area, and then eventually you'll rub off whatever's on the glass and allow you. And you can see how this is bleeding into that, and that's what I want. I kind of push it a little bit, like I said, until I get it like I want it. And again, however heavy you want these colors, if you want them more solid, which I've done, you just would use less water and more product, heavier, thicker product. Okay, when I shut that, I got a little bit of a splatter there. So now you know how to fix that just by just touching it with a damp brush, and it will blend. And again, I'm going to tilt this just a little bit and let that run. You have to watch all the area of the glass when you're doing this, because you don't want everything just to run off of the piece. And the paper towel also aids you in picking that up. that out, so I'm going to let it kind of run down a little bit. Okay. And like I said, you can mist it to diffuse it, or add extra water so that it runs and blends even more. And that's how you do a water-type background, kind of a sky blending into the grass. The other thing, you'll let this completely dry, and you can put this face down on your firing paper if you want to. It will not hurt it. The color can go face down with our products, and you're good. So I will show you the finished product in just a minute. Okay, I'm back. Here is, and I've got a piece of paper underneath this. This is the background after it's fired face down. You can see how it has a matte finish on it. Can you see all that? And it fades from light to dark. Okay, so there's our wet one. And here is the one that's fired. Let me turn this over. And then you can now see that you get a nice watercolor or even a airbrushed China painted type look. And you can see all those colors. Hopefully you can see that. Okay. Thanks for joining me, and I look forward to next time.